The following material is the sole property of Rock Talk Productions and is protected under applicable copyright laws. The words Rock Talk are a registered service mark, and this is the sole property of Rock Talk Productions. The excerpts you are about to view were taken from two Rock Talk specials which previously aired on KTNV, the ABC affiliate in Las Vegas, Nevada. The intent of this brief video is to better acquaint you with the production and segment contents of Rock Talk and the on-camera appearance and personality of host Dennis Lee Askew.
People who made threats against you, and there was a bomb threat, I believe.
Yeah.
And
There was a bomb threat when we opened up for New Riders of the Purple Sage. About 5 seconds before we went on, they called up and said as soon as we walked on the stage, a bomb was going to go off. And the guys in my band take it. We take it.
What's your name, please?
Mike Green.
And what'd you buy, Mike?
I bought the new ELO record.
What's your name?
Angie Blaylock.
And what'd you buy?
I bought Journey and Foreigner.
What's your name, please?
Phil Shin.
And what'd you buy, Phil?
I bought Donna Summer's old album, Love to Love You, Baby.
That's why they do it, right? So they can sell albums.
Okay, thank you.
One of the most popular Las Vegas bands to ride the crest of new wave music is LaJump. Here they are in an exclusive Rock Talk performance doing Lonely in Love.
You fill me up, make me high, there's no control. But I see it much clearer now, it's in the show. Sometimes a fantasy is not what it appears to be. It's been so locked away, but now I hold the key. Lonely in love, lonely in love, lonely in love, lonely in love.
Welcome to this month's edition of Rock Talk. On our program this afternoon, we'll see video performances by super hot female vocalist Juice Newton and re-rising ex-Traffic star Steve Winwood. We'll take a look at some album releases, profile the rock quintet Little Sister, and look into the news of the realm of rock and roll as our video magazine continues after these messages. Remember an English supergroup who was known for their wild album jackets and hosted the talents of Greg Lake and Pete Sinfield? Well, King Crimson is back after 7 years, and the only original member left is Robert Fripp. But that hasn't stopped the band's progressive creativity, as former Yes drummer Bill Bruford and Talking Heads confidant Adrian Belew are adding the needed elements to reunite the group with their following. For King Crimson, the album Discipline will put them back in touch with the public and their musical direction. Will the Rolling Stones play the entertainment capital of the world? Singer Marlena Ricci has been recording an album at Rust Sound in Los Angeles in conjunction with her recent transition from middle-of-the-road stylings to rock and roll. And session men on the date include the backup singers from Pink Floyd's The Wall and keyboardist Greg Matheson. Journey tickets sold so fast that Van Halen might have to take a second seat in sales times comparisons. Drama has lost the talents of guitarist Chris Mahoney and drummer Michael Graves, but not their knack for originality and showmanship. And George Thorogood was visited backstage in Salt Lake City by a woman who was on horseback, according to the promoter Michael Skivo. The woman tied the horse's reins to Mr. Thorogood's guitar amp and stayed for the after-the-show party.
Coming up on Rock Talk, Steve Winwood, album releases, news, and profile of Little Sister.
Former Traffic member Steve Winwood has found favor with American audiences once again by hitting the charts with Night Train from his Ark of the Diver album. Hear now an excursion on Steve Winwood's Night Train.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome back. A revised biography of the late Jimi Hendrix by author David Henderson, appropriately titled Excuse Me While I Kiss the Sky, is making an impact in bookstores. This is an encouragement to the publisher's Bantam book to seek other rock and roll stories that will interest readers and increase sales. Well, he certainly didn't have trouble finding a record label for his new self-entitled LP. Former ELP vocalist bass player Greg Lake has finally released his first solo album on Chrysalis Records, appropriately entitled Greg. Alvin Lee has released his first solo album on Atlantic Records called RX5. Genesis fans will have a love-hate affair with Abacab as the promise of the LP's hit single No Replay at All is fulfilled. A collection of great rock and roll tunes has been assembled by MCA Records, and the result is Hooligans, a perfect collaboration of songs by The Who. The Police have attacked new wave rock once again with Ghost in the Machine. Joan Armatrading sheds all her fears and phobias by walking under ladders. And Synthesis Larry Fast has released yet another Synergy album called Audion. Fast recently held the position of keyboardist for Peter Gabriel. And as for Blue Oyster Cult's Fire of Unknown Origin, on a more serious note, I would like to take this opportunity to offer my sincere condolences to the friends and family of Mike Powell. Mike died on October 27th, and an investigation into his death is underway. He was the drummer for local rock and roll band Cliff Sealer and one of the group's main sources of creativity. Mike Powell, who was 22 years old the day before his death, will be missed as he was a fine person and a talented musician. Sister is Fred Woods, Dale Benninger, Rachel Lehman, Robert Windolf, Michael Cromier, and they are hot. Sister has been together for almost 2 years, and in that short period of time, they have been an opening act for Ambrosia, placed in one of the top three positions in both the Las Vegas Battle of the Bands and Vegas Rock Wars, and have played Gazzari's, The Troubadour, UCLA, and Valley West. Once started, they have yet to stop.
Why the name Little Sister?
Something cute and bratty, I think. Something you can identify with. Everyone needs a little sister, right?
Right.
Production.